Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for the introduction. Actually, this is the outline of my presentation. After a quick overview on the voltage mode Hall sensor, I will try to introduce which is the main contribution to the open literature of this work, which is the use of the Hall sensor driven in the current mode. After that one, I will let's say describe which is the circuit implementation of the readout circuit of our microsystem, and finally we'll provide some measurement results and followed by some conclusion. Actually, as I guess every one of us knows, the Hall effect has been discovered in 1879, and how it is working basically, when you are applying a bias voltage across the Hall plate, this is imposing a fixed current I, and this current basically, well, the charge carrier of this that are bringing this current are sensitive to the Lorentz force when a magnetic field is present perpendicularly to the device, and this force is going to disturb the current distribution, resulting in a potential difference across the output. And this signal then is available for further amplification. Actually, conventional voltage mode Hall sensor use the cross-shaped, let's say, structure in order to optimize, in order to actually to reduce which are the Hall offset and to improve the sensitivity of the device, which is here given. As I told, okay, Hall sensor are conventionally driven in the voltage mode. What does it mean? It means that, as I mentioned, there is a bias current here, which is injected in terminal D and collected from terminal B, and in a in presence of a magnetic field, this is ending up generating an output voltage at terminal A and C, and this is the so-called Hall voltage. Many applications are there for this kind of sensor, spanning from biomedical application to contactless current sensing or application in the automotive sector. What's new in our paper, in our work? The idea, basic idea, is to drive the sensor in the current mode. What does it mean? It means that the output of the sensor is a current and not a voltage anymore. Actually, how it is working? It is working actually while using this first the same structure of the conventional Hall sensor, so the cross-shaped sensor, so as it is possible also to compensate for the offset caused by any mismatch by using the conventional current spinning technique. And how it is working our device, actually what you have to do is to inject the current into two consecutive arms of the cross-shaped device, for instance here A and B, and to collect the two output current from terminal D and C. If there is no magnetic field and if there is no mismatch, obviously the bias current is going to be divided into two equal parts, so I bias over two from each branch. But what happens is, if there is a magnetic field, then this magnetic field is causing an imbalance of the two output currents. And what we did is to combine actually two Hall plates in what we called twin current mode Hall sensor. In this way, we are injecting a current IB1 into two terminal of Hall plate A, and we are sinking the same current IB2 from two consecutive arms of the Hall plate B. In this way, if there is a magnetic field, actually the sensor is able to provide a differential output current which is equal to 2 IOHL. So actually we are able to double the sensor sensitivity with respect to the conventional implementation by using this twin sensor. This slide shows some COMSOL simulation, preliminary COMSOL simulation, which is showing the surface electrical potential on the two plates and also the current flow. So actually there are the arrows, which is, let's say, which are giving the direction or the, and the distribution of the current. Bias current is actually here fixed in 12 microamp, which is injected in terminal 1 and 2 and collected from terminal 3 and 4. The applied magnetic field is as high as 10 millitesla, and actually this light is also giving the size that we used for our sensor, which is 8 micrometer by 8 micrometer for each plate. Actually, how is done the readout of our sensor? Actually, this is the block diagram of our microsystem. There is the twin sensor, as we discussed it. There are the current spinning switches for offset cancellation. Actually, the two output differential current of the sensor, IHN and IHP, are injected basically into a chopped integrator. And actually, the advantage of having a current as an output signal is that the integration of the output current over a defined time period actually determines an output voltage with a gain which is proportional to integration time, right? So this is the main idea. The amplifier used for as an integrator, it is chopped in order to cancel out the offset of the amplifier itself. This is the general scheme, let's say, with some inset figures. Okay, do not care too much the details of the transistor. We will discuss that one shortly. What I was wanting to point out here is that, how it is working our measurements. Basically, as I told, we have a differential output current coming from the sensor. After a reset of the integrator, there is a time period, which is phi m, in which the input current are injected into the integrator. Phi m is a time period which is equal to an integer multiple of the current spinning cycles, of course. And when this period is finished, so phi m is open, then there is the current from the sensor are not injected into the integrator anymore. And the two output voltage of the amplifier of the integrator are then fed to the output pad by means of a simple switched capacitor filter, which is actually just a simple RC filter. This has been done, during the measure, the output of the integrator are are unloaded basically. And then when the measure is finished, the two output are fed to the output pad by means the RC integrator, the RC filter. This is in order to not load the integrator with the large parasitic element of the output pads. Actually, the twin sensor needs a common mode control to be able to fix, actually to control the common mode voltage of the output. How it is working, basically there is a current generator, I bias, which is injecting a current into the whole plate number called A, and there is the same current is systematically, decreased while being mirrored from to sink the current from the plate B, in order to leave room to the common mode control, which is actually here highlighted. It is working by mirroring a current imposed by transistor M12, which is then mirrored, and then it is adjusting the common mode equal to the desired value, which is actually half of the DDD. This is the schematic diagram of the amplifier that we used in the integration. Actually, as you can see, is a two-stage amplifier. The first stage is a telescopic cascode, and followed by an inverter with a cascode inverter with a cascode load. And actually, to leave room to the chopper out of the current in the first stage, the output voltage of the first stage is shifted up by means just a level shifter to the second stage. The simulated DC gain is 109 dB. And the GBW is 11 megahertz. This is the four possible configurations for the current spinning. And there are four positions, as in the conventional, let's say, technique. This needs to use 32 switches, which are, let's say, have been implemented as complementary switches. Let's come to the measurement section. This is the cheap microphotograph and with a, let's say, a zoom on the active area. The technology that we used is a 0.18 micrometer standard CMOS 6 metal 2 poly level technology. The active area is 300 by 200 square micrometer. Nominal supply voltage 1.8 volt, and actually nominal bias current for the sensor is 12 microamp. The current spinning frequency that we used is equal to 1 mega. This slide is giving the the cross section. I'm sorry. The cross section and the top view of our let's say of each of our whole plates. Actually, the whole plate is done, has been fabricated, realized as a low-doped N-well. And actually, to reduce flicker noise and surface carrier losses, we placed a P-plus layer, which is covering the surface of the active area of our device. Then the four contact regions are N-plus. As I mentioned, the size that we somehow optimized is 8 micrometer by 8 micrometer. These are the measurements results that we collected on our microsystem, so at the output of our system. This graph is giving the differential output voltage as a function of the magnetic field. We applied the magnetic field in a range between 0 and 6 millitesla. And we collected the differential output, actually, which is ranging from 0 actually to almost 120 millivolts around the common mode. And the slope of this curve is 20 millivolt over millitesla. And actually, we can, let's say, actually evaluate the residual offset after the current spinning, which is in the order of 50 microvolt. And also, this graph is giving the nonlinearity error, which is actually ranging between minus 0.2 and plus 0.2%, which is actually equivalent to plus minus 12 microtesla. This is the, let's say, the output voltage of our microsystem in a transient measurement. We can, as I mentioned, the output pad of our microsystem are kept equal to the common mode, which is 0.9, and then when the, let's say, integration time is finished, we are enabling the RC filter, which is actually making settling this output voltage exponentially within a 30 microsecond to the, let's say, to the final value, which in this case was equal to the VCM plus minus 60 millivolt. The voltage sensitivity at 25 kilosample per second is actually have been calculated as 1,660 volt over ampere over millitesla. And finally, I am coming to the conclusion. So in this paper, what we try to present has been a magnetic current mode microsystem, which has been implemented in a standard CMOS technology with minimum length, which is 0.18 micrometer. We validated basically the idea of using a twin current mode sensor, which is able to provide differential output current at the output node. And actually, this has the same capability of normal, say, conventional voltage mode Hall sensor to compensate for the offset due to mismatch in the fabrication by means of the current spinning technique. And actually, we proposed a readout circuit, which is consisting of a chopper current integrator, which has the advantage of having a gain which is proportional to the time that you are, let's say, available to wait. And actually, the measured power consumption of our microsystem is in the order of 120 microwatt. So this concludes my presentation.